own show, my career would go, and I would have to do 12 steps every day.
Trying to move your head. Now there's enough you Mistress of Mayhem, Hurricane, Summer, Isha, Mirage. Savannah.
Special was behind your back. So turn around and I'll be focused.
6.
Then in love.
featuring Syimone, Mathews. Savannah, Lynn.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the keeper of the keys, the countess of the clique, the mistress of Murderer's Row, Matron Mama Morton.
Tell you I'm the biggest mother. Thank you.
presentation category, contestant number one. Gentlemen and distinguished panel of judges. For your consideration and approval, I am contestant number one, Kitty Carlisle. Tonight is Derby City EOY, so we must consider the Derby, and that would be a win, place, and a show. Show win is tonight, place, the connection, show, you're looking at it. Thank you once again. I am contestant number one, Kitty Carlisle. Number one, Kitty Carlisle.
Estimate number two. Give it up. I'm coming. I'm coming. I want the world to know. Got to let it show. I'm coming. I want the world to know. And everywhere gave me this award tonight, and I accept it from you and only you. I love all of you.
Today I want to be a day to give the best of me.
Hurry! once before, there is no place in this world I'd rather be than here with you tonight, and I mean that. So I want you guys to sit back, relax, and enjoy the contest. Thank you.
Thank you, contestant number two, Ms. Rod Love. Turning in our cleanup crew, the Dr. Cleanup. Good. Ladies and gentlemen, if you will, please welcome on stage. In presentation category, give it up for contestant number three.
Funny how a lonely day made the person say, what good is mine?
She's wearing my hair.
Funny how a breaking heart can make me start to say, what good is mine? Funny how I often seem to think I'll never find a dream in my.
Impersonation and pageantry. And as I look back over my life, I'm 37 this year, and I can honestly say pageantry has been my life. Tonight, I'm competing for Derby City Entertainer of the Year, and this is my second time around. So I plan to represent to my best abilities and go on to National Entertainer of the Year, hopefully representing Derby City Entertainer of the Year, to be Louisville's first representative to capture the national title. So I invite you to sit back, relax, and enjoy me as I present my life. Thank you.
Welcome to the stage.
Hard.
Entertainer of the Year, Dee-Ranged.
Thanks, Harry. She did make me crazy. Just a little bit. How we doing, Lil? Excuse my pussy. I got the queefs. It happens when you have so much air pounded into you. Any givers out there? You got a what? You coming to make my pussy queef? I'm nervous.
Well, I've seen her pound somebody's pussy in a hotel room.
Well,
hurricane. Hurricane. I saw Hurricane pound some boy.
Hold on, wait. Wait, I'm talking. Wait, Asia. Yeah? What? Am I doing questions?
Yeah.
Yes, you are.
No, you're not doing questions.
I'm not. You are.
I'm seeing anywhere. Hurricane's not supposed to be out there.
Hurricane, go pull a curtain.
You're right.
Here, I'm going to do this for you. Come here. Hold on.
On this particular subject. Once again, in your bio you told us the one thing your Southern Baptist preacher father taught you is to stand up, don't correct him, is to stand up for what you believe in. Please tell me the difficulties of coming out to a Southern Baptist preacher father, and if you haven't come out to him, tell us why you haven't taken his advice on this particular subject. Good luck.
Once again, I'm contestant number one, Kitty Carlisle. Probably about 22 years ago, I did come out to my dad. And he has stood behind me 100% of the way. Last year, for the first time, on my 45th birthday, he finally did tell me he was proud of me. And they've seen pictures of me when I've been previous pageants and they're proud. He's stood by me 100%. And one thing I do know is that he loves me and my mom loves me and give me all the support I need. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kitty Carlisle. Love.
Thank you. welcome. Isn't she? I was with her at her first show. I'm so impressed. Wow. She's come a long way. She looks good.
She really does.
I'm going to let the judges ask you your question twice, and I'll take the opportunity to let you answer. Ladies and gentlemen, Mirage Love.
Hi, Mirage. How are you?
I'm good. How are
you?
You
look beautiful. You really do.
Thank you. So do you.
I'm going to ask you again. I'm just going to go ahead. In your bio, you stated that you're currently the show director at the Yada Club just outside of Cincinnati. Tell us how being a show director as compared to just a show girl can help you as an entertainer prepare yourself for a contest such as Entertainer of the Year.
Thank you. In response to the question, how being a show director has helped me grow as an entertainer and will help me in competition, it's helped me to truly understand the meaning of being humble. Being a show director, you meet hundreds and hundreds of different personalities, and every personality does not mesh. So you have to remember to stay humble, because those same people that you see on your way up, you'll see on your way down. If you're not a humble person, you're never gonna make it to the top. And that's what my goal is in life, is to make it to the top the best way I possibly can. So as a show director, how that's gonna help me grow in entertainment and competition is I will be the most humble contestant and performer you'll ever meet. Thank you very much, and I hope you guys enjoy the show.
Thank you. I heard last night was pretty rough, right? Who was here last night? Anyone? Without the fake applause? Anyone watch the fireworks? Were they nice? They sucked? It was cold, right? Move to Florida. I did. Now I'm tan and everything. Ladies and gentlemen, in creative evening, we're gonna put your hands together. This is your contestant number 3. Let's hear for Domanique Shappelle. Domanique Shappelle.
Hi, Domanique. In your bio, you told us that you just captured your third national title, Miss Ebony International. with the two others being Miss Liberty International 2004 and Miss Continental 2005. Tell us what you've taken from those three national titles that would help in representing the EOY system if you were to move forward here and then win EOY's national title. Again, you told us in your bio that you had just captured your third national title, Miss Ebony International, and the two others being Miss Liberty International 2004, Miss Continental 2005. Tell us what you have taken from those three national titles that would help in representing the EOY system if you were to move forward tonight and win the national title. Good luck.
Thank you, Asia. Ladies and gentlemen, for your consideration and your approval, I'm contestant number three, the French doll, Domanique Shappelle. When I first won my first national title, it was Miss Liberty International. And I faced so many obstacles because I didn't know as a national title holder that you would be even more critiqued by your peers. With that, I had to learn that my appearance is most important because you're representing not only yourself, but the system within itself. When I captured my second national title, Miss Continental, I learned that professionalism is the most important key to a successful rank. I had to know that not only that my appearance had to be up to par, but I also had to be a businesswoman, representing the system and the prelims that connect to the system. And once I won Miss Ebony International, it gave me acceptance amongst my black peers. And with that, I felt complete and loved. With those three things and those three titles that I won and captured, it allowed me to get more prepared and become a better representative for you as an Entertainer of the Year. I stand here before you competing for Derby City Entertainer of the Year because I want to be your next National Entertainer of the Year. And what better way than to represent National Entertainer of the Year than right here from the Derby City. Thank you.
Dee-Ranged, I'm Syimone. I'm going to be asking you your question.
Thanks, Syimone.
As being National Entertainer of the Year, you travel from town to town, city to city. Oh.
Same thing.
Yeah, that pretty much. What is the one thing you'd like to tell all of the young boys or daddy types in the bars that you meet?
Right together, girl.
We had this conversation and interview earlier today, didn't we?
Yes, we did.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm your contestant number four from Orlando, Florida. My name is Dee-Ranged. To all the young little boys and all the big daddies out there, I am 100% versatile. I can be real rough to my little twinks, and I can take it like a little bitch from my daddies. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm your contestant number four, Dee-Ranged.
And she's newly single.
I am single for a few months. Are you going to be my daddy? That's no man's land, bitch.
It'll eat you alive.
DJ, I don't know where the first one is, but we're going to go with the second one, okay? First one? She's here?
The list,
that's not the first one.
The list is on the table.
I know, but we're missing. It's like a
I'll put all three
Amber alert. Amber alert in the audience. Amber alert.
I'm sure
Hurricane
has something to do with it. Yeah, she picked up the wrong one. The bitch is blind in one eye.
And blonde in the other.
But you look good, girl. You look
still got a shag carpet.
Do it.
Top to bottom, honey. Top to bottom.
Hurricane doesn't wear panties.
Ooh, those were stains?
Skin marks and all.
I am a cold, I talk.
What'd you say? You're a coal miner's what?
No, I haven't.
She sharded, bitch. She sharded.
Oh, scratch it, Baloo.
Is that
scratch
how you wipe
Baloo.
Yourself here in Louisville? Jump on a pole?
Only if we need
I never wipe, bitch. I just saved it for next time. It happened. Ladies and gentlemen, I got this confusion. I know what's up now. Without further ado, let's welcome to the stage. She's a former Miss Derby City. Let's hear it for Deja Mirage.
You're gonna say
sounds good.
Your current reigning Derby City Entertainer of the Year, Savannah Lynn. Please welcome to the stage, former Derby City.
For one of our former Kentucky Derby, please give it up for the registered sex offender. Give it up for Syimone.
Listen to the song here in my heart, a melody I start but can't complete. Listen to the sound from deep within. It's only beginning to find release. Oh, the time has come for my dreams to be heard. They will not be pushed aside, turned into your own, all 'cause you won't listen. Oh!
Dirty City Entertainment of the Year, the Duplex Stream, Syimone, Mathews.
They don't know nothing. All this stuff been warmed over and redone, and it's all right. I'm glad they're getting it. I've been in this business for a long, long time. And even I didn't know where the music was going for a while. And I was saying, when are they gonna find that magic? When is the music gonna get back to simple and basic? Cause I wanna go back. I wanna go back to a time when the music touched your heart and your soul and your mind and your body. I want to go back to a time when there were blue lights in the basement. Y'all know what I'm talking about. I want to go back to a time when slow dancing was still in style. And when you got out on the dance floor, you touched your partner. You didn't have to look for them.
Saying,
boy,
giving him Hurricane Summers.
There are three well-known young ladies.
Hurricane Summers. That means clap.
One of the craziest things that ever happened to me was what a woman wrote to me about this next song. She used it to break up with her abusive husband. Settle down. She packed her things, loaded them into her car, and went back in one last time to put on CD. She pressed repeat, and then she walked out. Later that night, when he came home, she wasn't there. But I was. And this is what I see. It's finally over, but I can't even cry. So don't you give me no sweet talk. You done told you last night I was your puppet, just a dancer, dancing on the street. When the sun went down last night, Lord, it changed everything. Today I feel different, 'cause now I can see that you care more about yourself than mistreating me. It took me a long time to figure it out, but misery and pain.
Mr. Savannah, Hurricane Summer Shore.
And you have it on three words. On lights. This is your contestant, number one, Miss Kitty.
Carlisle.
Give it up for Kitty Carlisle. Let's hear it. Let's hear it!
God, I'm 14 years old. I've always been a good girl. Maybe you can give me a sign. Let me know what's happening to me. One day, my daddy comes and say, you're gonna do what your mom wouldn't. Now, I got two children from my daddy.
Ain't nothing for you, here. I don't never want you messing with that mailbox, you understand? That's my business. I done fixed that mailbox so I can tell if it be messed with. You understand? Hoppo, saddle my horse.
Yes,
sir. Celie, I'm going out for a spell and I want my supper when I get back.
Yes, sir.
I don't need love me. I got my sister. I can feel her now. She may not be here, but she's still mine. I know.
You're ugly, you're a woman, you're nothing at all!
Until you do
right by me, everything you think about is gonna come. You're doing this. Trade places. We would have been. So you do right by me, everything you even think about gonna fail.
Then right before the commercial go off, here come the motherfucking side effects. a warning. This medicine will give you a headache, insomnia, and constant diarrhea. Now you got to decide whether you want to have a runny nose or a runny ass. Which way you gonna eat? I wish men had a motherfucking side effect label right on the side of your ass. Let a bitch know up front what your ass is all about. You in a club, you chilling. He walk in, you looking good, and he looking good. He checking you out, you checking him out. Right before he walk past, you see his motherfucking side effects. Warning, this nigga is subject to run up your credit, fuck about two or three of your girlfriends, and has a tendency to whoop a bitch ass in his house. What you gonna do? You know a bitch like me will go ahead and fuck with him anyway if the dick is good, you know? Nigga might change, nigga might change. But I had a dream that I was standing at the gates of heaven and got into a fight. Wasn't my fault they was fucking with me in line. Let me tell y'all how the shit happened. Foxy Brown, the rapper, is standing in front of me. So Foxy Brown gets up to the gate. She said, how you doing, St. Peter? She said, my name is Foxy Brown. I'm a rapper. I've done some sins in my life, but I'm still a good person. He said, Foxy Brown, my child, what part of your body have you sinned with? She said, my hands. He said, go over there and rinse your hands out in the faucet, and you may enter the gates of heaven. Next, it was my turn. I went up to the gate. I said, how you doing, St. Peter? Done some sins in my life, but I'm still a good person. He said, my child, what part of your body have you sinned with? Before I can say any fucking thing, Monica Lewinsky pushed me out the way and said, excuse me, but can I rinse my mouth out in the faucet before this bitch put her ass in the water? Talking about dicks, because I wasn't gonna bring up dicks, but since y'all brought it up, let me ask y'all a question. Why is it that men with little dicks act like they don't know they got little dicks?
Like the dick just got small on the way to your house.
I ain't got time to be bullshit.
Shut them down.
It's a beautiful thing. Oh, y'all don't know dick like I know dick. As a matter of fact, I think we should just lock all the doors and make all the men in here just pull their dicks out. Now look at the men with little dicks. They sitting there like, now this bitch ain't funny. What the damn? But you know it's one big dick country motherfucker sitting way in the top like this. Lock the door. We go through a lot of shit, but the amazing thing about us ladies, we have the ability to bounce back because we made like that. Ladies, when you was about 8 years old, your mother put you outside on the front porch and she gave you a hula hoop. You didn't quite understand why she insisted that you learn how to do the hula hoop. You got outside with the hula hoop rocking around your waist. After a while, when you got it rocking to your own certain pattern, it made a certain sound that says shh, shh, shh. And when you heard that sound, you knew you was the shit. So I say to my sisters here tonight, next time that you have to remind him of just who you are, the next time that you up on top and you riding real good, I want you to look at yourself in the mirror, wink one eye at yourself and just say shh, 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 shh.
Jimmy, don't forget. If you don't get help in J.D., I can get help somewhere. Ladies and gentlemen.
Like AA.
AA, please. Fucking egotistical assholes. They said I had to take the trip all the way up here. Please give it up for National Entertainer of the Year. This is Deranged.
Touch the moonlight. shooting stars. You're holding heaven in your arms. Have you ever been certain love? Have you ever walked on air? Ever felt like you were dreaming? When you never thought it could, but it really feels that good. Have you ever been so love? Have you ever been in love? You can touch moonlight. When your heart is shooting stars, you're holding heaven in your arms. Yeah.
Mirage. Please welcome to the stage former Derby City Entertainer of the Year, Kelly Mathews.
Satan's trying to stop me and to place
special dental room. Louisville, Kentucky. You can check her out on Syimone.com. Also, ladies and gentlemen, you can check her out Thursday nights at the Pink Door, and ladies and gentlemen, Tuesday nights at Fusions. Ladies and gentlemen, if you will, currently working at Play Nightclub, Nashville, Tennessee. Give it up for the Diva Extreme. Let's hear it for Syimone.
Thank you.
extreme Syimone. And now, please welcome to the stage in her final performance, Miss Derby City Entertainer of the Year, Savannah Lynn.
Kentucky Derby, please give it up. Miss Kelly Mathews. Thank you, I'm sorry, Miss Deja Mirage. Give it up for Miss Deja Mirage. Ladies and gentlemen, another former, please give it up for the fabulous Miss Kelly Mathews.
Shappelle!
for her. Give her up.